welcome. This is Reef Kaur Sahani to Watch News X. Let's take you through the breaking news of the hour. Encounter continues in Mandli area in Kathua. Two terrorists have been neutralized in the encounter, as well as one police personnel has been martyred. Two people have also been injured in the gunfire between security officials and terrorists. The search operations are underway. Additional forces have also been deployed to neutralize the terrorists. Viewers, it's important to note that this comes right when the elections are taking place in Jammu and Kashmir. As we all are well aware, Jammu and Kashmir saw its second round of polling on September 25th. This, of course, happened after a hiatus of 10 long years in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. We saw certain very prominent faces contest the second round of polls in Jammu and Kashmir, which is, of course, due for also the third round of polls. We have some important information, like I mentioned, coming in from Mandli area, where an encounter has taken place in Kathua. Two terrorists have been neutralized in the encounter, as well as one police personnel has been martyred. This, of course, is some crucial information coming in. Meanwhile, my colleague Ajay Jandal joins us on the telecast. Ajay, what can you tell us about the search operations that are underway in the Mandli district of course, Kathua?
Yes, the operation still continues, and it was last evening when security forces got some specific input that some terrorists, which is about 4 to 5 in number, they are hiding in a house, in this Kog village immediately, because this is a house inside a forest area. So immediately operation was launched and search was started. And when terrorists they were basically have seen that the security forces they have gotten off them. They immediately opened fire on the security forces in the initial gun battle. Three police personnel were injured, including two officers, and they were shifted to hospital, in which one police head constable, he attained martyrdom, whereas operation still continues. Our sources are saying that there are possibility that two terrorists are killed, because the bodies which basically were lying over outside the house, during the encounter, that was spotted in the drone, and there is a possibility that these terrorists basically they might have killed in this exchange of fire those who were hiding inside house. But security forces are waiting for bodies to be retrieved, so that they can confirm that who they are and how much terrorists are still over there. Encounter still continuing, and search operations are going on, and security forces are trying to neutralize all the terrorists those who are present over here.
Ajay, I also wish to understand from you, how far away is this entire situation from residential areas, and have civilian life been impacted at all in this process?
Pardon, please repeat the question.
Right, I want to understand from you that how far away are these operations taking place, and have civilian life been impacted at all by what's happening in Kathua?
Where this operation is taking place, this is a Kog village area, and only 1 to 2 kilometer radius there are several houses of the civilians in that area, and this area also has to go for the poll on 1st of October, so during the third phase of polling. So definitely it seems that these terrorists must be hiding in that area. They might have planned to carry out attack on the civilians during the poll process, but forces action, on-time action, they have averted it, and now security forces, they are ensuring that all the terrorists, those who are hiding in this area, they can be neutralized, because this area is a far-flung area from the Kathua district. It is about 45 to 50 kilometers away from the Kathua town. So that is why it is taking time for the forces to reach over there, because where these terrorists are hiding, there is no road connectivity. Definitely weather is also a challenge for the forces, because during the morning there was a dense fog in that area, in and around that area where these terrorists are hiding in the house. So that's why it's a challenging situation for the forces, but Jammu and Kashmir Police and a special operation group of Jammu and Kashmir Police and Indian Army Special Forces, they are ensuring that all the terrorists hiding in that area, they has to be neutralized, because only about a week back, two terrorists were gunned down on a Kathua-Udhampur border, those who were hiding in the forest area, and warlike store was recovered as far as the weapons are concerned. So possibly these terrorists are also carrying modern weapons and communication devices, and that's why security forces are operating very cautiously, and during the night they just hold up the area, and the cordon was there, and with the very first light of the sun, once again, searches has been launched by the forces.
Right, thank you so much, Ajay, for joining us and sharing those crucial information. Meanwhile, we have more information coming in from Nepal. Continuous rainfall has led to severe floods in Nepal.